honestly, Piers, I think this is the wrong night to be doing this, and I really wish you'd waited to have this segment till after the funerals. This is a time in Colorado and nationally when it would have been better to have more of the segments like you did before with the family, and when people could be unified in helping the victims. Right.
Well, I mean,
now,
if I could jump
and
in there, let me challenge you on what you've just said. A lot of people have said that today. A lot of people who don't want strengthening gun control have said this is not the day to debate it. I tell you the day to debate it. It would have been yesterday to prevent this happening. When you have a young man like this able to legally get 6,000 rounds of ammunition off the internet to buy four weapons, including an assault rifle, and for all of this to be perfectly legal in modern America, allowing him to carry out the biggest shooting in the history of the United States, that, I'm afraid, means it's too late for this debate, for those people that lost their lives. So don't patronize me about when we should be talking about the gun control debate. You tell me a good reason why we should not strengthen the law now to stop another young man like him going into a store tomorrow, buying four more weapons, 6,000 rounds of ammunition on the internet, and killing and shooting another 70 people in America.
Because we don't even know the full facts of this situation yet, and that's another reason it would have been prudent for you to wait a few days where we know more about this. Nobody's been able to come up with any proposal specific about the facts of this case, partly because the facts are still being developed. And I know, Andrew, you've said many times on the air, America's got too many guns. You want to drastically reduce the number of guns. So if your whole point is there's too many guns, we got to get rid of lots of them, drastically constrict things, and you think somehow that's going to make it better, well, there's no real evidence that it will. If you want to talk about specific reforms that might involve this specific guy and prevent future people like him, that's fine. But let's wait till we find out the information instead of rushing this country into this pro-con thing that I know sells a lot of commercials on TV, but it's inappropriately divisive now. Nobody's stopping you from having the segment on Wednesday. Can you give people a little bit of breathing room?
Okay, you've made your point on that. Let's move to Dan Gross from the Brady campaign, because I'm really not interested in having a debate about whether we can debate gun control.